The shipping channel in Baltimore, Maryland, set to reopen by the end of this month, Transportation Secretary Pete Buttigieg told the BBC. He's fully confident by the end of May, the channel will be ready for normal operations. The economically vital channel in the Patapsco River have been largely closed since the key bridge collapsed in March, impacting supply chains. The bridge crumbled after being struck by a container ship, killing 6 workers.
The Philippines slightly narrows its debt-to-GDP ratio in the first quarter. The measure of the nation's public debt to its economic output stood at 60.15% in the 3-month period. This was lower than the 61% recorded last year, but remains above the level at the end of 2023. The government projects the full-year debt ratio to settle at 60.3%. Fiscal deficit, or the shortfall in state income compared to its spending, was also down 4.46%. The Philippines has National Security Advisor calling for accountability from China over the alleged recording of a conversation between a Philippine military official and a Chinese diplomat. Secretary Eduardo Año said the Chinese embassy's repeated acts of spreading disinformation and misinformation should not go unsanctioned. He also echoed other government agencies in saying the Chinese embassy is out to sow division among Filipinos. Año asserts what the embassy did is a serious breach of the basic norms of international relations and diplomacy. Fitch Solutions Unit BMI bullish on the Philippine economy following the release of the official first quarter GDP figures on Thursday. The local economy grew 5.7% in the first 3 months of the year, faster compared to the 5.5% in the last quarter of 2023. While this was lower than BMI's 6% forecast, the company noted that it expects growth to accelerate in the succeeding quarters as the Banco Central ng Pilipinas begins cutting rates in July. Now, the analytics firm, however, warned the El Nino weather phenomenon could affect food production and push prices further up. The Philippine president chides an erstwhile anti-narcotics agent for linking him to illegal drug use. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. spoke to media on Friday in his visit to General Santos City in the southern Philippines. He dismissed the Senate testimony of former PIDEA agent Jonathan Morales, citing the latter's supposed record of giving out false statements. Marcos was implicated in alleged leaked anti-drug documents along with veteran actress Maricel Soriano. Bluntly, the president called Morales a professional liar.
Mahirap naman bigyan ng importansya yan. You know, this fellow is a professional liar. At parang jukebox yan eh. Kung ano yung hulog mo na, basta maghulog ka ng pera, kahit anong kantang gusto mo, kakantay niya. Walang say-say.
The new leader of the Coordinating Council of Private Educational Associations of the Philippines, or COCOPEA, reiterating their group's concern over the possible entry of foreign schools and universities in the country. Lawmakers are tackling possible amendments to the Constitution that would allow the entry of foreign schools. COCOPEA Executive Director Attorney John Holmes said this could have an adverse effect on their members.
We argued that there is no urgent cause to amend the 1987 Constitution because there are immediate issues plaguing the Philippine education system. So instead, our time and resources should be directed towards addressing these problems in our educational system through proper implementation of existing laws and government programs. What is actually we're afraid about, of is, as I mentioned a while ago, we are already competing with publicly funded educational institutions. Now, increase in full ownership will lead to a more heightened competition because we believe that foreign institutions will have more resources, potentially attracting students away from local private schools.